Doc Raven be here. Look, I don't have much time, but with patch 6.1 for Endwalker coming on April 12th, I thought it'd be good to take a look at the Praetorium one time because it's no longer going to be Netflix and chill. I don't know if you've been under a rock or anything, but just come with me. We'll see this. We'll take it through. Have a good time. Oh, and like and subscribe if you want, I guess.
We'll be right back. chamber for the ultimate weapon.
Eorzea's unity is forged of falsehoods. Its city-states are built on deceit, and its faith is an instrument of deception. It is not but a cobweb of lies. To believe in Eorzea is to believe in nothing. In Eorzea, the beast tribes often summon gods to fight in their stead. Though your comrades only rarely respond in kind. Which is strange, is it not? Are the 12 otherwise engaged? I was given to understand they were your protectors. If you truly believe them your guardians, why do you not repeat the trick that served you so well in Cartano and call them down? They will answer. So long as you lavish them with crystals and gorge them on ether. Your gods are no different from those of the beasts, icons, everyone. Except for this, and you will see how Eorzea's faith is bleeding the land dry. Nor is this unknown to your masters, which prompts the question, why do they cling to these false deities? What drives even men of learning, even the great Louis Swan, to grovel at their feet? The answer? Your masters lack the strength to do otherwise! For the world of man to mean anything, man must own the world. To this end, he hath fought ever to raise himself through conflict. To grow rich through conquest. And when the dust of battle settles, it is ever the strong who dictate the fate of the weak. Knowing this, when a single path is open to the infinite ruler, that of false worship, a path which leads to innovation and death. Steer the course of civilization. And in this land of creeping mendacity, that one truth will prove its salvation. Come, champion of Eorzea, face me. Your defeat shall serve as proof of my readiness to rule. It is only right that I should take your realm. But none among you has the power to stop me!
We'll be right back.
Such power befits a ruler. Yet, you lack the resolve to put it to proper use. A waste. Allow me, then, hero, to do that which you will not.
Thank you.
the ultimate weapon is all-powerful. Why does my enemy still stand? Can his strength truly be so great?
It is the blessing of light that confounds you. Your foe acts under the protection of the crystal he bears.
So, this is what empowers him.
Beyond mortal limits. If you are to prevail, the Hammer of Darkness must needs be brought to bear upon the Shield of Light. And so it shall, for the Ultima weapon is host to a power of which you are as yet ignorant.
Speak plainly, Ascian.
The heart of Sabeek. It is the weapon's core, an enigma whose surface even the vaunted scholars of ancient Alec fail to scratch. The magic within has lain dormant for eons.
Of what magic do you speak?
A spell without parallel. Ultima. I sought the life force of the primals for no other reason but to quicken the core. For the true power of the Ultima weapon lies within its now beating heart.
Lahabrea, what have you done?
No more than was necessary for my god to be reborn.
Damn you, Ascian.
The hour is at hand. Behold but a sliver of my god's power. And from the deepest pit of the seven hells to the very pinnacle of the heavens, the world shall tremble. Unleash Ultima!
Such devastation! This was not my intention!
Oh, Hydaelyn, it seems the task of keeping your champion alive has exhausted what strength you had left. Van Belzar, your enemy's shield is broken. The rest I leave to you.
We will speak later, Ascian. But first, I must deal with you. The question of who is mightier remains. Come, adventurer. Let us find the answer together. Heed me. The subjects of a weak ruler must needs look to a higher power for providence, and their dependence comes at a cost to the realm. The misguided elevate the frail, and the frail lead the people astray. Unless a man of power wrests control, the cycle will never be broken. You of all people must see the truth in this. You who have the strength to rule.
You boasted of unrivaled power. You were entrusted with the ultimate weapon, the ultimate magic. And still, you failed. So much for the glory of man. Growing imbalance afflicting the planet must be redressed. If it is permitted to worsen, the very laws of existence, both etheric and physical, will be warped beyond all recognition. Know you the root of this corruption? Hydaelyn! Like a parasite, she must be burned out if the planet is to recover. And naught but the return of the one true god will ensure her complete excision. Yet, to pave the way for the Master's return, a chaotic confluence of untold proportions must needs be brought about. And that will necessitate the presence of the Primals. Needless to say, both you and your Scion accomplices cannot be suffered to interfere in this endeavor. You will not leave this place alive.
thou wouldst pierce the shadows, make thee a blade of light.